हेलो एवरीवन, क्लास सेवन। आई एम राशिद खान फ्रॉम लक्ष्मी प्रसाद मेमोरियल पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। क्लास टू ईयर विल हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट द चैप्टर नंबर 11, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन। एंड इन विच रिप्रोडक्शन द सेकंड टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, दैट इज अ सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू गो थ्रू द चैप्टर। Now we can go through the second type of reproduction, that is called as sexual reproduction. So we can say this is the type of reproduction in which reproduction in which there is two type of sexes are required. That means the sexual reproduction is a reproduction in which two male and female gametes are required to generate a new species. So what we can say, it is the reproduction, or it is the common method by which a organism and plant may be produced by the two different parents, that is a male gametes and female gametes, by the fusion of a male gamete and female gamete. So we can say that if there is a flower, so that will be the causes, or that will be the resultant of the combination or conjugation of a male gamete and a female gamete. So wherever the plants grows, the flowering plant grows, that only the utmost reason to grow into the new by the sexual reproduction. And this sexual reproduction occur only when there is a male and a female gamete fused together, are combined together, so produce a new young ones. So here we can show about what is the male gametes and what are the female gametes, and it has the two types. First one is unisexual, next one is bisexual. What does it mean, unisexual and bisexual? Suppose if there is any plant in which a flower can grow, this can have both male and female gamete, male and a female gamete with a single flower. So that one is called as a unisexual. And in which if there is a male and female gametes are separate male and female gametes, that one is considered to be a bisexual. The flower in which either male or female gamete reproduce, it is a part of a plant present, is called as a unisexual. And in case if there is a both sexes are present, both gametes are present in a such type of a flowering plant, that one is called as a bisexual. For example, mustard. So here is the example of car in unisexual. Popcorn, the popcorn, papaya, cucumber, papaya and cucumber. In case of a bisexual, there is another example like mustard, rose and mustard, rose and peanuts. That are all the two different types of unisexual and bisexual type of a plants. So here we can see that there, what are the different types in which the male and female gametes reproduce. So here we can see about that the male reproductive part and female reproductive part. Reproductive part, female reproductive part. What should be the female reproductive part? So here we can write, in case, that is, we can draw here. This one is considered to be as a reproductive part of a flower, that is this can termed as female reproductive part. What it can have or what it should have, that one is called the stigma, that is style, and here is ovary. And if we are talking about only the ovary, so this can be represented as in that form. So this must be a part of a female reproductive part, and that one is considered to be the pistils. Pistil of a flower, that is a female reproductive part. Other is called as a pistil or carpel. The carpel consisting is stigma, style, ovary, ovules, whatever, etc. And the rest of this can have ovary. In case of ovary, there is a ovum, are a very small form of ovules are present over there. So that is the female reproductive part. Now we are talking, we are going to talk about the male reproductive part. Male reproductive part. What should be the male reproductive part? Here we can write, this is male reproductive part. Male reproductive part. It is said to be a main reproductive part, in which that can consisting of what actually there is the red one, it is called anther, and this one is called filaments. So these are two structures in which anther and filament. But the structure of anther you can see over here. These we have, these are all actually the anther. Anther and this one containing a minute filamentous powdery form structure that is called as pollens or pollen grain. This is the male reproductive part, that is anther filament, and that one is considered to be as what actually that are the mostly called as both of them is stamens. The male reproductive part as the female reproductive part is called as the carpel or the pistils. So on that basis here is the male reproductive part, that one is called as a stamen, in which there is an anther filament and anther having a small powdery structure, that is the pollen or the pollen grains. So in that concern we can say these are the two important male and a female reproductive part we can write here. Now we need to move to the next one, that is pollination. What does it mean about the pollination? Pollination is the process of transferring of the pollen's grain, the transferring of pollen, that is male gamete, from anther to the stigma. If there is a transfer of pollen takes place from the anther to stigma, so that one is considered to be what? That is called as a pollination. Suppose if there is a flower, So these are the anthers and these are the stigma. So whenever these pollens are transferred from anther to the stigma, when the transfer of pollens takes place from the anther to the stigma, that process is known as pollination. Now pollination has its two types. What are these? If the transfer of pollen grains from the stigma to anther takes place on a same plant, of a same flower, of a, on a same plant, so that one is considered to be as the pollination, as a self-pollination. Now if the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of a same flower to another stigma of another of on a same flower, suppose if it is transferred to this on a same flower, if these pollen grains are transferred, not only this, transferred to of the same flower and another stigma, so that one is considered to be as the cross pollination. Or if suppose the pollen grains that transfer from stigma to the anther of the other flowers, so that one is also considered to be as the cross pollination.